Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
So hello students, next topic is angular motion. We've already seen what linear motion is, there are what other different parameters involved in it. Now let's see what angular motion is and what are different parameters involved in angular motion and how both are related to each other, linear and angular. So this linear motion, you had linear velocity, linear displacement, linear acceleration. Similarly, in angular motion, you'll be having angular displacement, angular velocity, and angular acceleration. So angular displacement is nothing but the angle covered in a given amount of time. So the angle motion along a curve is nothing but angular displacement. Linear displacement is motion along a straight line. Angular displacement is motion along a curve. So theta, it is denoted by theta, which gives you the angle, that is the angle covered. Since in angular motion, you'll be having some angle that the link or a body will be covering in a particular amount of time. So that you can define by the term theta. It is denoted by theta. Next is angular velocity. Angular velocity is denoted by a Greek alphabet omega. So like linear velocity, it is nothing but rate of change of linear displacement. Angular velocity is nothing but rate of change of angular displacement. So angular velocity is rate of change of angular displacement, that is angle covered per unit time. So that is all about angular velocity. Next term is angular acceleration. Angular acceleration is denoted by a Greek alphabet alpha. It is rate of change of angular displacement, that is d omega by dt. Now let's look at the units. Angular displacement is theta, that is angle covered along the motion along a curve or angle curve that the body will cover. So it is denoted by the unit it will be having is radians. We cannot use degrees because degree is not an SI unit, so we have to use radians. The unit of angular displacement is radians. For radians, you just write the first three words RAD, radians. Angular velocity is nothing but rate of change of angular displacement, so it is radians per second. Angular acceleration, the unit will be radians per second square. Since it is rate of change of velocity, that is d omega by dt, so it is radians per second square. So these are three terms that is involved in angular motion. So I hope you've understood the basics of this chapter, first linear and angular motion. Now we'll be going deep into the chapter and try and understand how they're related to each other, how the velocities of different lengths will change when the length moves. So these are three terms involved in angular motion: angular velocity, angular displacement, and angular acceleration. So we've seen the units, we've seen the notations, we've seen how they're related to each other, we've seen the mathematical formula, omega is d theta by dt and alpha is d omega by dt. So that was all about this topic. I hope you've understood this. Thank you so much.